We have described the genus Homo and then moved to Ardipithecus and Australopithecus. Now it's time we start describing a new genus, and that is of the Paranthropines. The first species in this genus that we are going to talk about is Paranthropus Atheiopocus. Now this species is thought to have descended from Australopithecus afarensis, and therefore some call it by the name Australopithecus Atheiopocus. This species was originally proposed in 1967 by a team of French paleontologists to describe a toothless partial mandible that was thought to differ enough from the mandibles of the early human species known at the time. The fossils were discovered by Yves, Coppens and Camille, Arambourg in the Shungura deposits at the site of Homo in southern Ethiopia, and they initially assigned them a new genus and species, Paraustralopithecus Atheiopocus. When it was still debatable as to whether they actually had a new species, the discovery of the 2.5 million year old black skull in the West Lake Turkana region of Kenya by Alan Walker in 1985 put any doubts to rest and finally named it Paranthropus Atheiopocus. The black skull was a magnificent find. The almost complete skull was stained from manganese. It probably went so well to sing a scary song when introducing the black skull. Anthropologists suggest that Paranthropus Atheiopocus lived between 2.7 and 2.5 million years ago. Features include a flat cranial base with a small brain, long molars and a prognathic face, although it had a robust skull, face and mandible. It also had a powerful jaw and a well-developed sagittal crest on top of the skull, which indicates huge chewing muscles, with a strong emphasis on the muscles that connected toward the back of the crest and created strong chewing forces on the front teeth. Paranthropus Atheiopocus had a brain size of only about 410 cubic centimeters. Besides these characteristics, this species is still much of a mystery to paleoanthropologists, as very few remains of this species have been found. With fossils found in areas of eastern Africa, including Turkana Basin of northern Kenya and southern Ethiopia, the environment of the habitat was found to be favoring the species with dietary adaptations that allowed them to survive. And the shape and large size of the teeth indicate a largely vegetarian diet. Well, that is all that we have on Paranthropus Atheiopocus for you. Thanks for watching, and hope you enjoyed the video. Do tell us what you think of this video in the comment section down below. For more videos like these, remember to check our channel out, and please do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella, and see you soon in our next video.